Maybe you got started with Notion and you didn't take advantage of some of the settings and abilities. So we're going to show you 7 settings you can use to upgrade and get the most out of it as a newbie. Let's jump in. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Sensama. You can check them out below, but Sensama is a daily planner app that uses AI to help you to organize your tasks more effectively. It also has a bunch of features to help you better balance work life. You can find it linked below, and thanks to Sensama for sponsoring this video. The first Notion setting you can use is Suggest Edits. Now, this is a great way to collaborate seamlessly with other people in your team. It allows you to propose changes without altering the original content, ensuring that everyone's input is considered. It's a great way to quickly edit stuff without the need to jump over to a Google Doc, and also that suggested edits actually appears in the other person's account so that they can easily approve them or deny them, and naturally help the document move forward. If you're somebody that has lots of meetings, well, you can connect up Google Meet and Zoom inside of Notion. And all you have to do is have Notion Home enabled, the widget for Notion Calendar, and everything set up with Notion Calendar. Once you've got this all whirling, and I'll link to a good video below on how to get started with that, you can then have meetings come in with or without conference links, which is helpful because the ones with conference links to Zoom and Google Meet will allow you to join instantly without leaving your workspace, keeping everything centralized. Next up is the ability to customize your pages. This will allow you to have more consistent headers, footers, and styling, and make your Notion workspace look more cohesive. And this can be done in the top right of each of the pages and allow you to even remove things like comments, unnecessary footer detail, and much more. And it's something that a lot of people, when getting started with Notion, really miss out on, and something that can really just improve some of the minimalistic elements that Notion do so well on. Next up, if you want to pin your most important page and land on it every single time you open your Notion, then there's a great way to do that. Inside of settings, you can actually change what page you open when your Notion opens up. And this can be set to home, the last page you activated on, or the top page in your sidebar. So what you want to do is favorite the most important page in your Notion account, and it'll allow you next time when opening Notion for it to open on that page. This is perfect if you're setting goals or things that you want to, visualize when you start the day, whether that's a mood board or some projects that you're working on. Whatever you want, you can have it easily when you open your Notion account. Next up is a command shortcut for search. Now, obviously this can be set to the default, but obviously you can change this in settings. And if you go to my settings, scroll down to command search shortcut, you can change this from here, allowing you to customize what the trigger is for the command search. This is perfect because if you have a common trigger that you use, for example, it's command K for superhuman, then you don't want that to be used maybe here, or maybe you do, to save you time. It'll help to streamline your workflow, and it's a great way to get started. Tip number 6 is to turn any page into a wiki. Now, this is great if you want more accessible navigation and organization. And if you're looking to create knowledge bases or documentation, this is going to be a great way to do it. And you can do it with one click. All you have to do is press turn into wiki, and there'll be a few prompts in teaching you how about it works. Well, if you've got pages in there ready, it will do it for you, but there's something inside of wiki called verification, which will allow you to set verification for each page that you have inside of that wiki area. This is great if teams want to keep knowledge updated and just have a refreshed set of eyes on when and who accessed the page last. And finally, if you don't know yet, you can use tabs in the desktop version of Notion. This is perfect for multitasking and visualizing anything alongside each other. Whilst you can't break them out into windows, it's great for swapping different tabs and moving across a little bit like you use with a browser, and allows you to flexibly open multiple tabs for projects, enhancing your productivity. So folks, hopefully those Notion tips were helpful. Please do let us know if you have any questions in the comments below. And thanks to Sensama for sponsoring today's video. You can check Sensama out as they're on a mission to help you to be better in work-life balance and to be more mindful about what tasks you choose during the day. You can check them out below. Thank you very much. Do check out Toolfinder if you're in the hunt for tools.